Good afternoon, everyone. Today we'll be discussing about the for loops. For loops are nothing but when you are set to multiply iterating the values. I'll be using the concept of iteration. Iteration is nothing but I want to run the loop multiple times. Okay, I'm printing the values multiple times till I get a result. I'll be having one condition. Till that, I'll be using the loops and I'll be executing. That is it. We are for loop. So let's check what and all comes in the for loop. Already you know some knowledge about for loop. The for loop mainly it consists of the three factors within the loop. It consists of three factors. When you consider here, you can check out. You have the initialization, you have test, and you have the update, which is there in the for loop. And in between you have the statements which get executed. Okay, initialization is nothing but I'll be initializing, I'll be taking one value and I'll be taking that value, I'll be initializing to zero. So each and every time when it is set to be running, it will be incremented here. Update means what? At the end of the level, I may increment. And in between, I'll be testing the condition. Okay, if I have a value I and if it is being set to some value m, if I take the value of m, this I value, it will be iterated till 5. How it is? I take 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and less than 5 means what? Less than, till 4 it gets executed, your I value. Okay, 5 times it gets executed till your condition becomes either true or false. These are the factors which are there in the for loop. Okay, your initialization, your boolean test condition, update, and the loop, it is said to be present. Okay, in the loop condition, as I said, it consists of what? It consists of a certain value which is being initialized to certain 0, 1, 2, 3, whatever. From that value it starts, your loop starts. Okay, that is said to be your initialization, where it will be let the loop start with certain value which is being assigned to it. Okay, and another factor, when you consider the second one, which is that it is said to be tested, mainly that value is being used for the testing condition. For example, here it is number less than 10 is what? Your number here, it starts from 0, 1, 2 till 9, which is nothing but less than 10, your loop runs till the 10th condition. And each and every time, if I want to increment it, it will be here you have the result either true or false. Okay, here whatever it is, its value, it is said to be true or false. Okay, so when it is coming to the update section, it's nothing but the incremental section. Here what happens when the loop is okay, here it becomes 0, next it has to become 1. When it becomes as it tests the condition, then it increments it. Okay, it runs the condition, it runs the loop, and then the value of that particular number gets incremented. And once again, it tests for the condition, then once again, it gets incremented. Like that is your for loop. So here you can take an example which is being given here. So here an example is given of what? It's like printing the number. Whichever number you consider, it's starting from 0 and it is said to be less than 10. Okay, and each and every time your number gets incremented. So it starts with 0, it tests whether that number is less than 10. Okay, this is true. Then here it comes, it prints that value 0, and then this condition comes, this particular value 0 gets incremented, it becomes 1. So 1 less than 10, 1 prints. Okay, once again comes here, the value becomes 2. 2 means what? It comes here 2. 2 less than 10, yes, it prints. Okay, then once again it incremented by 1, it becomes 3. Then 3 is printed till the number 9. 9 is less than 10, so till 9 it gets printed. And afterwards, when it becomes 10 less than 10, the condition becomes false and it will come out of the loops. This is one example. Another example is being given here. It is said to be calculating the factorial. So here condition is what? Your I is said to be 1. Okay, then I less than n and I plus plus, and the factorial is equal to fact cross I. Okay, you can say fact is equal to fact cross I, it will be there. So here I, it is said to be starting with 1. Okay, I, let me take n as 5. Okay, your n variable as 5. So 1 is less than 5. Condition is true. So it comes here factorial. What happens? Factorial in the initial stage, it is set to 1. So what you have factorial is equal to fact cross I. So your factorial now it is what? It is initialized to 1. So 1 into your first I value is 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. So it takes 1 value and it gets executed. okay, afterwards one into one is one, result would be one. Okay, result when it takes one, your factorial becomes one. So next, once again when it is set with that, your I value is being changed. So one into two it will become. So it will be two now. Now factorial becomes two. Two, then once again your I increments by one, it becomes three. So 2 into 3, 6. Okay, factorial becomes 6. 6 into, once again your I value becomes 4. So it becomes 24. So like that, till the value, when it is said to be less than n, if it is less than n means 4. 4 is less than 5. So that condition, it gets executed and it comes out of the loop. Okay, like this way the for loop gets executed. This is an example how, what condition I gave you. Here you, they are said to be using two values, n and m, in the loop. Okay, in the initial stage I is set to be 0 and less than m, each and every time if I consider a static value m as 5. Okay, so each and every time when I am calculating, I gets incremented by 1, 2, 3, like that. Okay, and the result is what, in the initial phase it may be 1. Okay, your decimal result, it's 1. Okay, 1, and your result multiplied by n is nothing but 1 into n value. When in the beginning it will be 1, afterwards it becomes 2. Same way your result also becomes 2 into 2, then 3 into 2, like that it gets multiplied. At the end you will be getting the result. The loop runs one by one and at the end you get the result. This is one form of your for loop. Then another form of for loop is your for each loop. When I am considering the for each, it has the concept where it has a syntax here, type element and collection. For each, it's nothing but it will be considering each and every element within the loop and it prints those particular elements on the screen. In the beginning, in between you have the statements and you have the number of elements which are being printed, and the collection of elements, it may be in the array format or any other format which you accept, or in the listed format it may be present. So example, here you can see a string is being given. Here a string of elements are being given. String days, you can check out, the days are Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So for each string type, okay, string type, day in days, that is being considered, and it will be printing the days one by one by day. For example, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, like that, it will be printing in the for each. For each is nothing but for each element which is there in the particular array or string or any other enumerations or something, it considers that and it will be printing. That is said to be your for each loop. And another part is there the for loops, it is your nested loop. Nested is nothing but within a loop you have another loop, then it is said to be a nested loop. Okay, composition nested is within the loop, another loop it will be there. So this is the syntax for it. You have the same concept, initialization, test and update. Here also initialization, test and update, and your statements are said to be present. And in the nested loop you have an example, you can check out here, a small example is being considered. So you want to print a triangle format a numbers. So what it is being considering is, you are said to be using the number n. N is being considered here. So I want to compare the elements to certain format only I'll be taking, and the numbers it will be incremented one by one by one. Okay, it may be starting from one, so that particular element is being read here, your number is being checked. Okay, so n is nothing but I want a limit, so for that reason I will be using here. And for loop is being considered here, two loops are there, you can check, the two loops are for row and your column. So each and every element in the row and column it will be printed. For example, if I consider in the beginning, in the row the first element is 1. Okay, I consider first row and less than equal to n. N I consider is at as 5. Till 5 I will be counting. So 1 I will be taking. Then once again this here executes first row. Then in a loop, what happens, it will be considering your loop from 1 to 1. Okay, column also is 1. Your loop, row is also 1 and column also is 1, first row, first column, and column is less than row. So means what, row is also 1. So 1 less than 1, okay, it will become, so it will be taking only less than equal to 1. So it will be 1 and 1 only. So it will be not considering this factor, it will be considering only first row, first column, like that it takes and it prints 1. Okay, now here once again when it goes, when it becomes, your column becomes 2. 2 less than 1? No, it will be false and this condition fails and it will come out of the loop. And here once again it goes for your for loop. Now rows become 2. Okay, row become 2. Row less than 5. Yes, correct. It is true. And here it comes to the inner loop. Okay, now here once again it starts with the column 1. Row may be, row is nothing but your first row is over. Sorry. First row is said to be over. Now you have to consider the second row. In the second row you have what? Already your second row is being chosen. Okay. In the column now I have to choose the first column. First column and less than row. Okay. 2. It is correct. Then it will be printing what? 1. So next it gets incremented now column. Your column is said to be 2. Okay. It takes that and it will print that particular element there. And once again it comes, okay, 2 less than equal to 2. Yeah, correct, it will run. Okay, next time when it comes, now it here it becomes 3. So 3 less than 2, no, it will comes out of the loop. 1, 2 will print. Same way it will be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that it will check. And at the end, I have considered a int pass which is 5. Your n value is 5. So here n value, when it reaches... It reaches your fourth column, fourth row, what will happen? It is 4 less than equal to 5. Yes, this is also run. But when it becomes 5 less than equal to 5, here the loop becomes false and here also it doesn't go that to that particular column also. Okay, this way the for loop executes one by one in the execution of nested format. Okay, so today we have learnt is what is your for loop. In that you have for each loop, you can even assign, for example, you can have multiple variables here. Not only one variable, you can declare not only 3, you can assign 4 variables also within the line. So for loop can accept even multiple variables also. Remember that concept. So you have learned what is for loop, nested for loop and for each loop today. Okay. Thank you.